The Umayyad dynasty extended from Spain to the far eastern lands of modern-day Afghanistan. They reigned from 661 through 750 CE, and from the beginning, they faced opposition from their own people. The Muslims were heavily discontented with the corruption of those who sat upon the thrones of power. They were drunkards, whose hypocrisy was on the display in the land of the Prophet. Even the Prophet's family was not immune, as they became the target of Yazid's lies and slander. In the heart of Iraq, the desert of Karbala sprawls under the intense beaming sun. Hossein and his small band of family and followers are stranded without water for days. Between the Euphrates River and the grandson of the Prophet stands an army of thousands. It is noon, and the sun is high in the sky. Hossein inaugurates the Salat with a defiant Allahu Akbar. As arrows begin to rain down from the oppressor's ranks, this is Hossein's reason for battle, to uphold his grandfather's religion, even in the face of cruelty and death. The enemy is ruthless, cutting down one valiant believer after another. The corpses are many, old men, young boys, women, even an infant child. Zainab exits her tent and finds herself alone. The men are all slain, except for Hossein, the last warrior. She sees a white horse trotting back from the dusty battlefield. His mane is drenched in blood, and she knew the grandson of the Prophet has been martyred. Yazid killed him, and Yazid would now enslave her. 564 miles from Karbala to Damascus, Zainab was paraded through the desert, in chains, the veil torn from her face, and ahead of her was her brother's head impaled on a spear. She shuddered as the thought of his headless body that lay in Karbala, yet she proceeded with honor. Even despite this calamity, this heinous crime, she spoke of justice, of dignity, of righteousness. When she arrived in Syria, her captor and killer of her brother gloated, yet Zainab was not rattled. The arrogance of an oppressor does not affect those who stand on the side of truth, she proclaimed, her voice steady, strong, defiant. Your days are numbered, she reminded the caliph, and your name shall wither and rot with your death, yet the people of the earth will remember Hossein and his sacrifice forever. And they shall remember Zainab too, that resilient woman who stood in the face of the tyrant who thought he was God and showed him that he was nothing but dust.
What does Lady Zainab mean to you?